this is Brad Linder with Lilliputing, and this is Piper Computer's second generation DIY educational little laptop computing kit. And I'm here with Dave Lundgren, who is a little taller than me, so let me put what's up here.
Thanks for coming by to see us here.
And so you're CEO of Piper?
I am.
And so what can you tell me about the Piper version 2? How's it different from the first generation? Who's it targeted at? What's it supposed to do?
Well, I think the first thing is that we're now shipping the Raspberry Pi Model 3B version 1.2, which when we designed this kit last summer was absolutely the finest single board microcomputer in the world. We've redone our cabling to be both more rugged and more intuitive for kids to build. We've taken the old meatball speaker and created an acoustic suspension speaker enclosure in there with much better audio performance. A request from a lot of teachers, we've got a very accessible audio control, volume control, to turn the sound down because it really can crank some tunes. The biggest, most obvious change is we've got a really nice big 9.5-inch screen right now. We've redesigned the tool chest, the breadboard tray, the Pi mounting thing, nice big knurled screws now that make it easy to take the Pi out if you want to do something else with it. More milliamp hours in our battery, and I think one of the best changes we made is that there are no more wood screws involved. We have brass inserts in the wood, so it's all machine screw into machine threaded insert. You can disassemble the kit and rebuild it 20 times without appreciable wear.
And another difference I understand is that the first generation had to run off of battery power. This one you can actually plug in and charge at the same time, right?
You certainly can, and it's the easiest design in the world. It's simply a side plug that you reach through and line up your plug and plug in the battery. That's it.
So the whole thing
super
is running
simple.
Off of this USB battery,
yeah.
But since you can plug it in, you can run it and charge it at the same time.
And these have been running for about 2 hours here at Pepcom, and this one is still showing 4 bars. So you get a full day of play out of the battery.
So the screen's larger. It makes it feel, I don't know if I would say immersive, but a little bit more like a laptop.
Yeah.
And the original version was, what, 7-inch, 800 by 480? What's the resolution here?
This is a 1024 screen. So okay. we've got some real pixels going here.
Okay. And so this is targeted at young people who want to learn what?
Well, it's targeting young people that have an interest in STEAM, and what it really teaches them is the basics of 3 engineering disciplines: mechanical engineering, electrical engineering, and software engineering. This hinge, for example, is actually a 4-bar linkage. Electrically, you've got a chest full of basic components: switches, buttons, LEDs, buzzers, jumper wires, and multiple breadboards. What's, I think, most interesting about Piper is that there's plenty of teacher kid-to-code things out there, software, some hardware. This is a systems approach that really embraces the real-world fact that the important problems don't neatly fall into one of the engineering disciplines. You have to take a system-level approach and get software engineers, hardware engineers, and mechanical engineers all bringing their unique skills to bear.
And so, in terms of, you know, once this thing, putting it together in the first place is sort of the first lesson.
Yeah.
And once you do, there's sort of lesson plans and other sort of activities that you can go through?
There are. I mean, there's the 3D Raspberry Pi edition of Minecraft gaming experience with Piperbot and Pip, the robot and mouse respectively. Two very different characters with a lot of personality now in the new animations. And very different skills, strengths, and weaknesses. And they collaborate together to solve problems in the game in tandem and teamwork with the kid who's got the kit, who's solving and building actual circuits in the real world. It totally breaks the fourth wall. It merges the atoms of the kit with the bits that guide the pixels on the screen. It merges the physical and the digital in a way that we think is really important. It's sort of like a product where voltage, current, power, stored energy are as important as learning to code, because they really are.
And so what we're seeing here is, you know, this one's already configured. You've got different buttons that can perform different.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Cool. And so this is.
Kids can invent their own projects too.
And so this is something that's available retail for about $299 or so.
That's exactly it. Yeah,
it's also available to educators.
Yeah, and for educators, we have a very deep cloud-based curriculum that can provide dozens of hours of standards-aligned instruction.
And what would you say, I mean, see her ages 8 and up, like what would you say is the typical sort of age group for this sort of activity?
I think our sweet spot is age 8 to 13. We've seen AARP seniors personally buy these. So yeah, it's a pretty broad-based kit, but the sweet spot is really age 8 to 13.
Well, thank you very much.
It's been a pleasure, Brad.